In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, welcome to our Sunday service for Passion Sunday, the fifth Sunday of Lent. We're going to carry on our theme of Lent, of talking about creation. But before I do that, I have one very sad bit of news to pass on to anyone, especially those who live and know St Peter's Church and the Nene Crossings Benefice. I'm really sad to have to tell you that Anne Vimpany passed away yesterday. It was all very sudden and unexpected. It's not COVID related, as far as we know. Do remember her family and friends in your prayers. And so, as I say, we're going to start our service by hearing a hymn, Morning Has Broken, that follows this thought about creation. With you. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God shows his love for us, that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Let us show our love for him by confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Let us pray. Father, we confess to you our selfishness and lack of love. Fill us with your Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We confess to you our fear and failure in sharing our faith. Fill us with your Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We confess to you our stubbornness and lack of trust. Fill us with your Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And I see we've also received the forgiveness of the assistant curate, my dog, this morning. She's obviously having a spat with the cat. So let us pray. Most merciful God, who by the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, delivered and saved the world, grant that by faith in him who suffered on the cross, we may triumph in the power of his victory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. And our first reading today is taken from the book of Genesis, chapter 1, beginning at verse 20. And God said, "Let the waters teem with living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth, across the vault of the sky." So God created the great creatures of the sea, and every living thing with which the water teems and moves about in it, according to their kinds, and every winged bird according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. And there was morning, and there was evening, the fifth day. A holy gospel reading is taken from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 11, beginning at verse 1. Glory to you, O Lord. Now a certain man was ill, Lazarus of Bethany, in the village of Mary and his sister Martha. Now Mary was the one who anointed Lord with the perfume and wiped his feet with her hair. Her brother Lazarus was ill. So the sisters sent a message to Jesus, "Lord, him whom you love is ill." But when Jesus heard it, he said, "This illness does not lead to death, but rather it is for God's glory, so the Son of Man may be glorified through him." Accordingly, though Jesus loved Martha and his sister and Lazarus, after hearing that Lazarus was ill, he stayed 2 days longer in the place where he was. Then after this, he and his disciples said, "Let's go to Judea again." The disciples said to him, "Rabbi, the Jews are just now trying to stone you, and you're going there again." Jesus answered, "Are there not 12 days of daylight? Those who walk during the day do not stumble, because they see the light of the world. But those who walk at night stumble, because the light is not in them." After saying this, he told them, "Our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep, but I'm going there to awaken him." The disciples said to him, "Lord, if he's fallen asleep, he'll be all right." Jesus, however, had been speaking about his death, but they thought he was referring merely to sleep. Then Jesus told them plainly, "Lazarus is dead. For your sake, I'm glad I was not there, so that you may believe. But let us go to him." Thomas, who was called the twin, said to his fellow disciples, "Let us also go, that we might die with him." When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, about 2 miles away, and many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to console them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him, while Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he'll rise again in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world." When she had said this, she went back and called her sister Mary and told her privately, "The teacher is here and is calling for you." And when she heard it, she got up quickly and went to him. Now Jesus had not come to the village, but was still at the place where Martha had met him. And the Jews who were with her in the house consoled her, saw that Jesus get up quickly and go out. They followed her because they thought she was going to the tomb to weep there. When Mary came where Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who were with her also weeping, he was greatly disturbed and deeply moved. Jesus said, "Where have you laid him?" And they said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus began to weep. So the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?" And Jesus, again greatly disturbed, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone was lying against it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the sister of the dead man, said to him, "Lord, there is already a stench because he has been dead for 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone, and Jesus looked upwards and said, "Father, I thank you for having heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I have said this for the sake of the crowd standing here, so that they may believe that you have sent me." When he had said this, he cried out with a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out!" The dead man came out, his feet and his hands bound with strips of cloth, and his face wrapped in a cloth. And Jesus said to them, "Unbind him and let him go." Many of the Jews, therefore, had come with Mary and had seen Jesus, or did, believed in him. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We've reached day 5 of the story of creation. And we hear about the creation of the birds and the fish. But the phrase that really strikes me is the phrase that life was teeming. It makes it sound like a vast abundance of everything. And it made me stop to think about the nature of life teeming, being so massively full of such variety and such numbers going around. I'm trying to think of times and places in my life where maybe I've experienced or seen that. Sometimes if you've gone to the aquariums, these great huge aquariums that you have nowadays where you can go and walk underneath and you see the fish all filling these vast tanks around you. Or maybe if it's coming to teeming, you might need to think of cabinet rooms and coronaviruses. Teeming around, filling the space, for good or bad. Well, I think it does show us something about the power and grandeur and generosity of the God that loves us. Sometimes we have our own hearts set on such minor little things, or we have asked him for such small things, that we can forget the power and generosity and love of the God that we love. The overpowering urge and generosity. We got a glimpse of that just ever so slightly in our gospel today. The disciples thought that Jesus was merely talking about waking Lazarus up. In fact, it was a bringing back to life. And that wonderful phrase at the very end, which it all seems to be built on, about unbind him, let go of the fetters of what hold him back. Let us grow to be the full potential. Maybe that says something about God's generosity and love for us all. To be released from those things that hold us back, that keep us away, and release us into the full potential that we can be if we go in partnership and hold God's hands. Amen. So let us pray. Heavenly Father, at this time, when so many of us are stuck in our own homes, and so many of us have fear and dread, help us also to recognise that you are a God of generosity and love. Help us not to see ourselves trapped. Help us not to see ourselves alone. Help us to see ourselves safe and in your company at all times and in all places. And we give special thanks, Father, for those who are working so hard to care for those, especially those who are suffering from the coronavirus. For the doctors and nurses and those who work for the NHS. For those who suddenly have found that their ordinary, everyday, mundane, and maybe even unvalued work and occupation are now considered to be heroes, key workers. For those who work in the shops, who make the deliveries, who check on food supplies and bring electricity and gas and heating to our homes. For those who keep the streets safe and clean. Be with them, Father. Protect and help them. And we pray, Father, for the things that are still happening in the world, but which our own consummation and being so consumed by the events so close that we have forgotten. Remember those places where there is still war and hunger and injustice. Father, we may have forgotten them because of somehow this involves us, but we know in your generosity and love, Father, that you have not forgotten them and those peoples. Be with them. On this day especially, Father, as we remember the fifth day of creation, we pray for those who are on the seas, fishermen, those whose livelihoods are involved with delivery of goods across the oceans, for the international trade routes, for those who care for the maintenance and balance of the heat and acidity of our oceans and how that brings life to us all. Give wisdom to all of us as we care for the great resources that we have. I've been asked to pray especially by Sharon for her niece and nephew, for Becky and Zach, both of whom are doctors in an A&E department. Father, we give you thanks for their gifts and skills, and we particularly ask you to protect and help them at this time as they reveal your love in their care for others. Keep them safe and be with them. And we pray for those who are sick and ill, for those on our hearts, for those we worry about and miss. We pray especially for our families, those whom we're so used to seeing that we didn't think that there would be a time when we wouldn't see them so easily. For folk that we took for granted. And we pray especially, Father, for Sharon Powell, Anne Kitchener, Valerie Horn, Michael Bates, David McBride, Graham Sharpley, John Westwood, Anne Middleton, Dorothy Lewin, Steve Bowater, Harley Taylor, Jeffrey Groom, Rachel Stabler, Susan Goodband, Norma King, Joan Box, Kate Pode, Joy Bubb, Jane Appleyard, Margaret Jeffries, Carol Bettles, Finley, Sid Foskett, Esme Drage, Ted Bailey, Matthew Francis, Hilda Hartwell, Brenda Winterbone, Marjorie Wilson, Jan Bettles, and Alan Palmer. And we pray, Father, for those whom we love but see no more. In the silence of our hearts, we bring before you our own loved ones. And we remember those who have recently passed. We pray for Claire Massey and Gwen Frost. And today especially, we bring before you Anne Vimpani, that they may rest in peace and rise in glory. And we bring before you our own cares and concerns, Father, our own opportunities to give you thanks, to ask for your help, to bring before you our concerns or sorrows, knowing that you will hear our prayer. And as a God of generosity and love, of teeming life, you will hear our prayers. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. And so as I prepare for our communion table, I'm going to play our second hymn, which is I Am the Bread of Life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. God of mercy and compassion, your word calls us home to faith and love. Accept all we offer you this day, in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is indeed right and just our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For at the time of his passion and resurrection draws near, the whole earth is called to acknowledge his hidden majesty. The power of the life-giving cross reveals the judgment that has come upon the world and the triumph of Christ crucified. He is the victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever, our advocate in heaven, to plead our cause, exalting us there to join with angels and archangels, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. All glory be to you, our Heavenly Father, who in your tender mercy gave your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. He instituted, and in his Holy Gospel commanded us to continue, a perpetual memory of that, his precious death, until he comes again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we humbly pray. And granted by the power of your Holy Spirit, we receive in these gifts of your creation, this bread and this wine, according to your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body that is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup of wine and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant that is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, Lord and Heavenly Father, in remembrance of his precious death and resurrection, the mighty resurrection and glorious ascension of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, We offer you through him this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Grant that by his merits and death, and through faith in his blood, we and all your church may receive forgiveness of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And though we be unworthy through our manifold sins to offer you any sacrifice, yet we pray that you will accept this, our duty and service that we owe. Do not weigh our merits, but pardon our offences, and fill us all who share in this holy communion with your grace and heavenly blessing. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. And so, as our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy upon us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy upon us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We're not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. The body of Christ given for all. The blood of Christ shed for all. Lord Jesus Christ, you have taught us that what we do for the least of our brothers and sisters, we do also for you. Give us the will to be the servant of others, as you were the servant of all, and gave up your life and died for us, but are alive and reign now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Well, thank you for joining us. Just a couple of notices to give out, if I may. First of all, to say that our two Benefice newsletters, Saints Alive and Outlook, are being suspended from physical delivery, for certainly for this month, and who knows, maybe for next month as well, as it doesn't seem right and proper that people, the whole process of it isn't right. However, both magazines can be obtained by being caught or downloaded, and the best place to go for either of them will be our website, nencrossings.org.uk. If you find your way onto there, hopefully it's relatively simple from there to find your way into being able to download or read online both those magazines. But thank you to Nick, and thank you to Richard for carrying on editing those, even if we're not actually having a physical production. I am really grateful, and please do try and read through for one of those. Those things are all on there. As I always say, is there anything else that I've missed? But of course you can't respond and shout that out to me at the moment. What we are doing, we thought that it would be nice to encourage as many folk as possible to light a candle at 8 o'clock this evening and maybe say the day's collect that you can download, or to say a simple prayer. And then it's something that all of us, as a benefice, all the members of the church that can, are able to do. We've put that out on various different mediums. So I invite you, please, at 8 o'clock, to light a candle. It doesn't have to be in the window, it doesn't have to be anywhere, but to light a candle as a family together and to say a prayer together. And remember that not only are you joining together as a family, but the family of the church is joining together at that time as well. I'm going to play our final hymn today. Thank heavens for YouTube, you might say. And we're going to listen now to Lift High the Cross.
Thank you.
Christ crucified, draw you to himself, to find in him sure ground for faith, a firm support for hope, and the assurances of sins forgiven, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with each and every one of you today, and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord, in the name of Christ.